السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus, the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri Rahmatullahi Alayh.
Lesson number 920. A person who is noble and honorable is that person that he accepts the sensitivities of his wife and he doesn't go on a tangent when his wife is emotional or sensitive, he's not beating her or physically abusing her in any way. It's wrong for any person to go and abuse his wife physically or emotionally either way. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was such that he understood the sensitivities of women. He told Aisha radiallahu anha that, "Oh Aisha, I know when you're upset with me and I know when you're happy with me." So Aisha radiallahu anha says, "O Nabi of Allah, what would give off that indication?" He says, "Well, when you're happy with me, then you say, 'Wa Rabbi Muhammad,' that you take the qasam of the Lord of Muhammad. And when you're upset with me and when you're sensitive towards me, then you say, 'Wa Rabba Ibrahim,' that you take the qasam of the Lord of Ibrahim alayhi salam. That gives me an indication that you are upset with me." This hadith is made mention of in Ruhul Ma'ani, and this context is also mentioned in Bikr Moti, the 4th volume on page 20. A person who's noble, a person who's respectable, is that person who doesn't go about swearing, hitting, abusing physically, mentally, emotionally his wife in any way. In fact, the more you see to your wife, the more it shows your nobility. Hakim ul-Ummah, Hazrat Mawlana Ashraf Ali al-Thanawi rahimahullah, he makes mention of an incident that a person was particularly poor in a certain village. And because of that, they would live on the basics of day-to-day living. So what had happened was, at some point, because for a long time the person hadn't eaten of meat, he went and he bought some chicken. And when he came home, it was after 6 months they were partaking of this meal. So the salt was extra. So now he could either rant about it and he could say, "For such a long time we're eating our basic lentils and our basic veggies. Now when I brought the meat, you do this, you spoil the food." But in his mind he said, "Oh Allah, I would love that my son-in-law forgives my daughter for the mistakes that she makes. And I would love that he overlooks the faults of my daughter. So my wife, she's also somebody's daughter. And hence I'm overlooking his faults." So when he passed away, someone seen in a dream and someone seen him and asked him, "How did you fare in the court of Allah?" So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told this individual, "You done this wrong, you done this wrong, you done this wrong." This person realized, "I'm now doomed, because these are all the sins that has been shown to me." And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, "You know that once you forgave a slave of mine, and because of that today I am forgiving you." So imagine, just by looking after our wives, what lessons we can learn from here. Many people that are constant with their tahajjud, with their zikr, with their ibadah, and they don't have the company of a mentor, a spiritually pious, a ahlullah, then such people, they get angry very quickly. Morana says, this is my experience. But they say that anger is because of the effect of the zikr. Morana says the effect of the zikr will make you subservient, not anger. It's the shaitan's effect on a person. He said, it's better that a person looks after and makes sure that a person is good to his fellow Muslim brother. Why? Because the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that shows a complete believer is that person who loves for his brother for what he loves for himself, and a perfect believer is that person who does not harm a fellow Muslim person. So we can well imagine what must be the rights of our wife to overlook and oversee her faults. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the understanding. Today let us make an intention that we all look at our wives and we smile out of happiness. And the wives, they look at the husband and they blush out of love. And in return, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at both of them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy with them. And those of us that don't have any partners, well, look at the sky and be happy in return. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy with you. Allah give us the understanding. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.